Good day, students. Welcome to Mathgotserved.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to name polynomials. All right, before we get started with some examples, what we're going to do first is take a look at how to name polynomials using the degree of the polynomial expression and also how to name the polynomial using the number of terms. Okay, so what we're going to do is combine the strategy for naming by degree and number of terms in order to name polynomials by degree and number of terms. All right, let's start with the first one, which is naming by degree. Okay, so if you know the degree of a polynomial, you can use that information to name the polynomial. So let's go over the different names that the polynomials have based on the degree of the polynomial. On the first column, we're going to be placing the degree of the polynomial, and in the second column, we're going to be taking a look at what the name of that polynomial is based on the degree. Now, what if the degree of a polynomial is zero? Now, before we get started with that, recall that the degree is the highest exponent of the leading term of the polynomial expression. Okay, so the leading term, if a polynomial is written in standard form in descending order of degrees, the term with the highest degree, that degree value is the degree of the polynomial. Okay, so if the degree is zero, the name of the polynomial is a constant. If the degree is 1, then we have a linear polynomial. If the degree is 2, we have a quadratic. If you think about quadratic equations, the highest power or exponential value is normally 2, okay? So that's why they're called quadratic equations. If the highest degree of a polynomial is 3, then it is called a cubic. Think about raising numbers to the third power. What do you call that? It's called a cube, right? The cube of a number. So that's why we have cubic. It comes from the word cube. Now, how about a fourth degree polynomial? A fourth degree polynomial is called a quartic. Okay, like quarter, four, quartic is how you name a fourth degree polynomial. Now, what if you have a fifth degree polynomial? A fifth degree polynomial is called a quintic. Okay, so for Algebra 2 and in most pre-cal courses, these are the unique names that can be assigned to polynomials based on their degree. After that, you basically use the ordinal position of the degree to name the polynomial. So for example, if you have 6, this can be called a sixth degree polynomial, okay? A sixth degree polynomial. And then you just go on and on like that. So if you have the degree n, you call the polynomial an nth degree polynomial. So that's basically how you name polynomials using the degree. All right, now what we're going to do is name the polynomial using the number of terms. Okay, so naming by the number of terms. All right, so let's make a nice little chart here to help us see how to name polynomials using the number of terms that the polynomial has. Okay, so what we'll be doing after this process is basically looking at examples and combining naming by degree with naming by number of terms to determine the name of a polynomial. All right, so in the first column, we're going to take a look at the number of terms. And in the second column, we're going to take a look at the name of that polynomial based on the number of terms. Now, what if you have one term? A polynomial of one term is called a monomial. Think about words that have mono associated with them. So if you think about monopoly, for example, it's basically a financial system where one company dominates a particular sector. Okay, so mono, you think about one. If you have two terms, you have a binomial. Think about the word bi. It means two, like bi-weekly, every 2 weeks, or bicycle, that means two tires. So bi comes from, is associated with the word two. How about if you have three terms? Think about bicycles, right? Bicycles have two tires. What do vehicles with three tires, what are they called? They are called tricycles, right? So the name is going to be, you might have guessed it, a trinomial, okay? You can also think about the geometric figure. The triangle is a geometric figure with three sides, right? So tri and three. Now, these are the unique names that we have for a polynomial based on the number of terms. So subsequent number of terms will be named using that number of terms, okay? So if we have four, you would just simply say a polynomial with four terms. Okay, and polynomial with four terms. After this, we don't have any unique names, okay, after the third number of terms. So polynomial with four terms for four, and just follow that pattern. If you have n terms, you call it a polynomial with n terms, where n is an integer, of course. Polynomial with n terms, a positive integer. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some examples making use of a combination of information from these two tables that we have here. Now let's try out some examples. I have a chart here that we're going to be referring to just to assist you in naming the polynomials. If you like a copy of this document, you simply go to mathgotserved.com under Algebra 2. This lesson is under the unit on polynomials. So if you go to that page on the Algebra 2, you should be able to get a copy of this document to download for your future reference. Now let's take a look at some examples. Instructions are to name the polynomial by degree and number of terms. Okay, so name each polynomial by degree and number of terms. Polynomial number one. What if we have negative 7x plus 2? Let's determine what the number of terms are here. Number of terms. The number of terms, we have one, two, we have two terms. And the degree, what's the degree here? Now, when you want to find the degree of a polynomial, you want to look for the term with the highest exponent, the term that the variable has the highest exponent. Now, for negative 7x, the value of the exponent for x is 1. Okay, that's a default exponential value when you do not have any number indicated. This is a constant, but it has an exponent associated with its variable. The variable is gone. The reason that we do not have a variable here is because of its exponential value. X to the power of 0, which is 1. Okay, that's why it wasn't there. So 2, this 2 term has a degree of 0, and this negative 7x has a degree of 1. So which is the biggest out of the two? The biggest degree of all the terms is the degree of the polynomial. And as you can see here, the highest degree is 1. Okay, so what's the name of this polynomial? We have two terms, so let's go number of terms, two terms, which makes it a binomial. And we have a degree of 1, which makes it linear. Okay, so what's the name? The name of this polynomial is a linear binomial. Okay, you start naming it using the degree first and then the number of terms second. Let's take a look at another example. Number two, what is the name of this polynomial right here? Negative x to the second power. Let's start by determining the degree. Well, let's do degree first. It doesn't really matter. So the degree is the highest exponent. This is the only exponent that there is. So by default, it determines the degree of this term, which is 2. Number of terms. How many terms do we have here? We have exactly one term. Okay, so let's go back to our chart. If the degree is 2, that is a quadratic. Okay, and if you have one term, that's a monomial. So how do you name this? This is a quadratic monomial. So the name is a quadratic monomial. Let's take a look at problem number 3. What if you have the polynomial 5? All right, so what is the degree here? The degree of a constant is, remember, there is an x to the 0 hidden here. So that tells us that the degree is going to be 0 because that's the value of the highest exponent. How many terms do we have? Number of terms. The number of terms here is just 1. So if you go back to the chart, we have a degree of 0, which makes it a constant. And you have one term, monomial. So how do we name this? The name of 5 is a constant monomial. So that's the name of this polynomial expression. Number 4. What if we have the polynomial expression negative 2x plus 5x to the 4th plus 3 minus 2x to the 3rd? Now let's take a look at this polynomial. Let's start with the degree. What is the degree of this polynomial? Now, one thing you might want to note is that some problems might not be presented in standard form, okay? The terms might not be written in descending order of degrees, as is the case here. So you have to be careful. Don't assume that the first term of every problem determines the degree. You have to take the time to inspect the degree of every single term to determine what the biggest degree is. And as you can see, the highest degree is 4. Okay, the degree of this term is 1, 4, 0, 3. So the highest degree is 4. Now, how many terms do we have here? What is the number of terms? As indicated earlier, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. Now, how do you name a fourth degree polynomial with 4 terms? Let's take a look at our chart. If the degree is 4, it's called a quartic. Okay, and if you have 4 terms, you just name the polynomial based on the number of terms you have. So it's a polynomial with 4 terms. If we combine those two parts together, the name of this polynomial is a quartic. This is a quartic polynomial with 4 terms. Okay, so that's how you name it. Let's take a look at question number 5. Now, what if you have 5 minus 6x to the 5th plus x? The degree of this polynomial, the highest exponential value is 5. The number of terms is 3. So a fifth degree polynomial is called a quintic. And if you have 3 terms, that's called a trinomial. So the name of this polynomial is a quintic trinomial. Okay? All right, let's take a look at the last example for this clip. What if you have a polynomial 6x to the 6th power plus 4x squared minus 5x to the 3rd plus 2 minus 4x to the 5th? What is the name of this polynomial using the degree and number of terms? Let's start with the degree. The highest exponent here is 6. As you can see, we have 6, 2, 3, 0, 5. So the degree is automatically 6. The number of terms, let's count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have 5 terms. So the name of this polynomial is going to be a 6th degree polynomial with 5 terms. You notice if you have a degree greater than 5, you just name it based on the order of the degree, like 6th, 7th, 8th. And then if you have terms more than 3, you just name them by the number of terms, with 4 terms, with 5, as is in this case with 6, and on, okay? So this is the name of this polynomial that we have here. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. I really appreciate it. If this tutorial was helpful in your study of polynomial functions, do give us a thumbs up. Your positive feedback is very valuable to us. If you have any questions or comments about this presentation, just place your questions in the comment section below, and we'll be more than glad to respond. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.